There was really nothing to do in Ohio. I always remember like us just like having fun with like whatever it was, and we were always like bored and trying to find like fun little things to do. We kind of just made do with like whatever we could, I guess.
If it rolled, we had it. Two basketball hoops, we had two trampolines, bikes, footballs, baseballs, ropes to climb.
Go, Logan! Go, Logan!
Woo! It was good. We had a lot of fun.
I remember them just fooling around with the camera, like going to the park, and I was happy that they were doing that and not, I don't know, getting into other trouble.
We had so many fights like out here in Hollywood, like just because I felt like he was so selfish. We started in Los Angeles together and kind of like grew apart because all he cared about was like growing his brand.
I was impressed with their self-esteem because they were willing to take risks that other people weren't. Do you think you become such a big shot that you think you're above the law and you do the next 7 or 8 things that are just completely unacceptable?
Excuse me?
The backlash against the social media star who posted video of an apparent suicide victim is intensifying.
The video viewed over 6 million times in just 24 hours.
And the backlash was massive. People and creators of all sizes denouncing Logan Paul and this video. So many people sharing stories of people they lost due to suicide and some specifically hanging.
But he insists that he only did it to raise awareness about suicide prevention.
I think he's a complete and utter insensitive idiot. And
fucking sick. Fucking freak. Do you know that? Do you know how empty you are inside? You've shown your true colors to everyone now, bitch. It is over for you.
I obviously, as a person, as a human being, I was frustrated and pissed off and offended.
The idea that Logan Paul is doing anything worthy here is ridiculous. He is not.
A hero for a lot of kids is to Logan fans. And when I see that, I care so much.
I'm so disgusted.
How could somebody not realize how fucked up this is?
This crosses the line.
Doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever as a human being.
Go to a mall if you're that fucking morbid.
What's the next big thing, you know, just dangling in front of you? Like, what's gonna draw in more people to the channel? Me filming a dead body?
Bah! YouTube, which, yes, I know, gave you and the world that shithead Logan Paul.
I convinced this country to elect Donald. And I can do it again. Already auditioning candidates, got some prospects. Logan Paul.
I've made a severe and continuous lapse in my judgment, and I don't expect to be forgiven. I'm simply here to apologize. So what we came across that day in the woods was obviously unplanned. And the reactions you saw on tape were raw, they were unfiltered. None of us knew how to react or how to feel. I should have never posted the video. I should have put the cameras down and stopped recording what we were going through. There's a lot of things I should have done differently, but I didn't. And for that, from the bottom of my heart, I am sorry.
too many people don't want to sleep in the bed that they make. It's fans and awesomeness when it's going your way, but when you make a misstep and everybody's mad at you, it's mob mentality. If I want all the admiration for all the content I put out, if I take a misstep, I have to deal with the ramifications. I think the one thing that I'm obsessed with is accountability. You gotta sleep in the bed that you made.
Step one is simply just ask. Ask yourself, ask others, are you thinking about suicide? And I know that sounds like a daunting question, but literally that question can save lives.
And obviously while this video is incredibly important and essential to his recovery, I also think it's incredibly important and it does good by him putting this out there. But really all that matters is how he handles himself moving forward. It is very easy to say something. It is very easy to apologize, but who you are as a person, that is defined by your actions in life.
I think he became like a whole new person. Like I could see it in his eyes. He was depressed, he was sad, he was angry. I don't know if he thought everything was gonna come to an end, but like that's how I'm sure he felt, and like that's how it seemed like he felt.
2018's weird for me.
Every day that the hate just kept on pouring in, it was like piled on top of each other, and I think it got worse and worse as time went on.
And I was scared. Because I honestly thought it got to the point where like I would not be shocked if I woke up one day and somebody told me Logan was dead. Like it was that low. Every minute of every day he's getting destroyed by the whole entire world.
Oh, good thing I'm a weirdo and decided to save his fur. It's a good thing I'm a weirdo. Here's the first one. It's a good thing I'm a weirdo and decided to...
How would you feel if you were known around the world to make people laugh every single day? That was your goal. All you wanted to do is make people laugh. When people met me, they go, you're the funniest guy. You brought me through so many things. He's like, and that's what I held on to. That's what I pushed forward. I was known for making people laugh. And now, because one thing I did, I am the worst thing kids could ever look at.
But in real life, man, I am fucking struggling right now because when I'm forced to do something and it's not coming from a place of truth within me, it makes me incredibly unhappy. And I'm just in a fucking... I'm in a rough spot, man.
Here I am. It is my second time jumping solo, and I wanted to get my skydiving license to distract myself a little bit, take my mind off of all the negative energy that was happening in my life. And literally right off the bat, the worst possible thing happens in that my main parachute does not open.
Sleeplessly embracing.
After everything that just happened, now I literally am fighting for my life. 10,000 feet in the air. If I don't take the necessary steps right now, I'm absolutely going to die.
Hunger of the pine.
Almost instinctually, I'm glad to say this. There was no panic. There was no moment of like, oh my God, what do I do? This is it. My life is about to end. I did the emergency procedures. I looked red, peel pool, grab silver, peel pool. My main chute cuts away, and thank God my reserve chute opened. It all happened so fast. In my mind, it meant I am not ready to die.
Embracing.
your winner, KSI! Look at me now! You said before this fight, you had something planned. Is there anything you want to say to someone else?
Obviously, a man's got this belt right now. Any YouTuber wants it, you can come get it. Jake Paul, Logan Paul, any of the Pauls, I don't care. Bring it.
Got him.
Daddy's home!
Boy. Came here to close the deal? Okay. Let's close the deal, all right?
So let's close the deal.
50, get a deal done. August 25th, we fight. Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
No. All right. All
right. KSI versus Logan Paul, a boxing match is in the works.
This is going to be the biggest event in YouTube history. By far, possibly the biggest event on the internet ever.
Alright, I'm saying this now. Jake Paul is a pussy.
Jake Paul challenged Deji to a fight right on the spot.
You wanna fight me right now?
I fight you, you train however long you want, and Logan fights KSI.
I am going to fight Deji.
Oh, it's gonna be
insane!
My name is Milton LaCroix. Background in boxing, I've been doing it a long ass time. What makes me successful in what I'm doing is I break all the rules. I don't follow tradition. Everybody says box with your hands up, chin down. I threw all that out the window a long time ago.
Here, head up. Ready? Go.
So Shannon Briggs came and found me and said, I need to get my swag back. Since I had a different flavor of boxing, Shannon came, took him to like two world title shots. Some of them were champions. A lot of the guys who are trained as amateurs went on to do big things.
Want to get the party started right. Logan, you hit the ceiling. You gotta hit the ceiling. Try to hit the ceiling. Reach. Nah, don't stop. Don't stop. Keep on. You said you in shape. You said you can do this. That's right. You said I don't get tired. I don't get tired.
Okay.
Now turn your body. Look at the difference. That little bit is all I need. That's how easy you got to punch. That's it. Boom. That's it. No big deal. Forget about trying to rip his head off right now. Development. You can rip the head off later. It's going to come. Develop. Develop learning how to get from A to B. And once you get from A to B, then you fucking push everything behind it.
This ain't no game, dog. When knocked out on the canvas,
sir,
and your family's
sir.
Watching you,
yeah,
all you're going to hear is one, two,
why you
three, four.
You dumb piece of shit. What are you gonna do when you lose? What are you gonna do? You know, I've got an idea. This is what you're gonna say once you lose. I've made a severe and continuous lack of my judgment.
Stop it! Yeah, you fucking pussy! Yo!
You're talking a lot about January, not a lot about August.
We just finished the press conference. Tensions are high. This is definitely going to be bigger than I think anyone expects. He goes for the low blows. He goes for the force. He goes for January. And rightfully so, I get it. It's time to keep my head up. keep moving forward and focus on August.
Go, baby, come on!
He's never taken an L. And for him to have all these W's in his corner and then this L that just will not leave him alone, just one thing just will hit him and that just makes him lash out.
Whoa! Whoa! Let's go!
Hey man, sorry, not sorry. Oh! We call him the sniper!
Hi, Eddie! Headshot!
Yeah!
Oh! Oh, you missed! No!
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Erica.
You better fucking get somebody to order this fucking window
Erica.
Right the fuck now. Get the fuck out of it right now. I'm not fucking around.
Okay, for sure, man.
Definitely.
Goddamn security issue,
you fuck. Yo, shut up, Dad.
You know, when you get divorced and the kids are really young, which Jake and Logan were, and there was a lot of animosity from Greg, and he let the kids know that.
I don't know what happened in your life that you're this angry, but this is crazy.
Oh, it's disrespectful, you fuck. You did the same thing in Japan. Don't do it.
Oh, there it is.
You know, when Greg's frustrated, everybody else around him is frustrated because he does take it out on the people around him. I don't think he knows how to not do that. It's what Logan learned.
The fucking nerve you have. Holy shit.
Well, yeah, there, it is tough love. You know, listen, this my boys growing up, they'd whine about something. I'd say, get the fuck over it. Welcome to life.
By the time they left my house, it was all back to calm because my house was like that. There was no stress, no unhappiness, no fighting.
You know, everybody has their own idea of what's affecting them or not affecting them. You know, like when they were with me, they would work. When they go to Pam's, it would be goof off and Wawa time.
Okay, so what are we gonna do about you and I, where you're not mad at me anymore?
You could start by apologizing.
Well, I would have. You would have talked to me. If I would have known about you, I would have said sorry.
No, I know, but there's been a repetitiveness that is starting to worry me, dangerous to what Jake and I have built over the past 4 or 5 years.
I don't think it's fair that you are coming at me for what I didn't do yet.
No, that's not fair. That's not fair at all.
But Logan, come on, you did some stupid shit.
Uh-huh, two stupid things, that's it. Other than that, it's only fucking wins. And guess what? I'm not doing stupid shit anymore from now on in the future. But I can guarantee Jake will continue to do stupid shit, as will you.
Girlfriend now. What's up, babes? Let me show her a real man. Everyone has my back, and no one has yours, besides your ludicrous mom and your disgusting delusional dad. How are you gonna make not one, but two dumbass children?
Hey, if you want to ask about the two dumb children,
shut the fuck up.
Ask your mom. Ask your mom about the two dumb children.
Oh,
remember back in the day when you taught me to live and I taught you to pray. We went in the battle together, no matter the weather, we never delayed. You gave me commands, I always obeyed. I never let you go astray. I never thought I'd see the day that you would come and you betray me. I'm bigger, I'm better, my mind is a weapon. I run up a lid up, you try to break me down and I'ma just get up. They ask me how I did it, I'ma just tell them I rose up. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life. Coming back stronger. I will arrive. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life. Coming back stronger. I will arise. Staring at you from afar, analyzing every scar, asking myself how we got here. Remember, this is who we are. I am not here for revenge. I did not come to make amends. Not here to repent for my sins. I just came here to win. I just came here to end. I just came here to fight. Show you everything you said I couldn't be. I became overnight. This for the blood, this is for the tears. This is for my pain and my plight. Two walked in, but only one of us is walking out of here tonight.
Time. Break clean.
I need you to not call 10 seconds.
How bad?
But it's not 10 seconds.
How bad?
Ooh.
Okay, listen.
Those fucking hurt.
Okay.
Ow.
Okay. You're not using your one down. He's using your punch on you. You're one down. You're one down.
Motherfucker, it's hard.
Okay, punch it. Punch first. Wipe that up. One down. You gotta go one down. Time, gentlemen. Thank you. Thank you.
So, that was your death most difficult opponent?
Yeah. I just got the shit kicked out of me.
7 days before
the fight.
You didn't get this shit.
Bro, there were a couple hits.
Bro, you weathered the storm.
Straight up, there were a couple hits, bro.
You weathered the storm.
Where I was, I didn't know where I was for like a split second, and that's never happened before. I can take shots, bro. Like,
you can take a fucking punch.
But like, I got hit so fucking hard, and then Jake was like, come on, keep fighting. And I'm like, oh, I'm gonna get emotional. I was like, I've kept fighting before. Ooh. This is weird, bro. I didn't think I'd cry right now. This whole year has been a fight. I definitely ain't gonna stop in the ring. Ooh.
Thank you.
Welcome to the biggest event
in history, man.
Yeah.
Let's have it, boys.
This is crazy. You're about to see a huge fight between KSI and Logan Paul.
Jake Paul versus Deji the Tuck. There is a call to ride. No time to for the big punch to end this. Can he get it? The referee's going to set it for us. The towel has been thrown in.
The towel
has been thrown in by Deji's corner. And Jake Paul is your winner. States, it's Logan, the Maverick
fucking head.
He's fucked.
Yeah.
You're good.
Fuck the showboat.
You're in his head already with the showboat.
Listen, you won that round easy, 10-0. Back him up to the ropes.
His team believed that he got the win there.
KSI finished it stronger without the doubt, but it was a close fight.
We might see the arena react well or badly within minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, after six rounds of action, we go to the scorecards.
Referee Gareth Morris scores it 58-57. He has it for KSI. Our next judge has it even at 57-57. And our third judge has it 57-57. It is a majority draw.
It's a draw.
Prepare for both fighters after six straight rounds of boxing. The Nightmare KSI Logan, the Maverick Paul. This fight is a majority draw.
Well.
Wow.
Logan, earlier this year especially, a lot of people questioned your heart.
There can be no question your heart right now, man. You stay in there to the bitter end. You've had a hard training camp, Logan. What does it feel like? Is there anyone you want to thank for all this time you put in?
As most of you know, the beginning of the year,
I was at the lowest point in my life as a result of my own actions. And KSI, as much as I can talk shit and pretend like you're my enemy, brother, I do owe you a thank you. I do owe you a serious thank you. Shake your hand right now, brother, because I do owe you an actual thank you. You say you saved my career, and these past 6 months, you've allowed me to take a step back from the internet and once again realize who I am, because I was getting caught up in the internet bullshit and the vlogging, and I told myself at the beginning of the year that I was not going to let that become my legacy, and that I was going to not ask for forgiveness, but earn a chance to be forgiven. Have I earned that? Not yet. Not yet. But it is the start of a new Logan Paul, where every fucking day I craft a better version of myself. And KSI, for that, I do thank you, brother. Rematch is going to be fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, KSI and Logan Paul.
I don't know if pushing yourself to the limit is healthy, because sometimes when you're at your limit, you break. Daily vlogging was the thing that made me become this, you know, exaggerated version of Logan Paul.
Good morning, Logan! What's poppin'?
Trying to come out of that routine of, like, the vlog character has been such a blessing for me, because it has forced me to evolve as a human in my personal life, because I can do that now. To be a maverick, and that symbol, the idea of being independent and using your differences to make you stand out and succeed, is so true to me, and apparently it resonates with a lot of other people as well. But I think we're gonna do like a slight rebrand and stick some fuel back in the tank, because
to me, you're about to fight in one of the most watched fights in the calendar year.
Things just got real. They've turned pro, they've ditched the headgear. The rematch between these two superstars, now sponsored by Match from Boxing and Eddie Hearn.
When I first met Logan Paul, I was quite shocked. The size of him.
Dude, I'm...
By the way, I mean...
Especially now.
I truly believe that in LA, someone will get knocked out.
Y'all the ones that was here.
There is so much confidence that comes with actual skill. And I had a year and a half to actually learn how to box. Whose fucking idea was it to give me this much time to become an athlete?